Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. Today we'll be going through NEET PG one-liners from medicine. This is part 1 of the medicine series, and in this video we'll be going through all one-liners from the topic respiratory medicine. Most common symptom of lung carcinoma: cough. Surfactant production starts at what week of gestation? 20 weeks. And it appears at 28 weeks in amniotic fluid. So both of these questions could be asked in respect to surfactant production. Investigation of choice to identify foreign body in airway: bronchoscopy. Most common source of hemoptysis: brachial artery. Most common opportunistic infection in HIV: tuberculosis. Most common cause of fungal pneumonia in HIV: pneumocystis jirovecii. Drug of choice for aspergillosis: voriconazole. Confirmatory test for interstitial lung disease: lung biopsy. Bilateral upper lobe bronchiectasis suggests diagnosis of cystic fibrosis. Bronchiectasis is most common with which lobe? Left lower lobe. Normal pulmonary capillary wedge pressure is 6 to 12 millimeters mercury. Drug of choice for management of pulmonary edema: furosemide. Most common cause of hemoptysis overall: tuberculosis. Source of hemoptysis in mitral stenosis: bronchial vein. Source of hemoptysis in tuberculosis: pulmonary artery. And this is known as Rasmussen's aneurysm. This is a very famous MCQ and also a very famous Viva question for university exams. So source of hemoptysis in mitral stenosis is bronchial vein, and source of hemoptysis in tuberculosis is pulmonary artery. Most common intrabronchial cause of hemoptysis: lung carcinoma. Paradoxical inward movement of rib cage during inspiration is known as Hoover's sign. Stony dull note on percussion is seen in pleural effusion. Type 3 respiratory failure is defined as perioperative respiratory failure. Criteria used for diagnosis of ARDS: Berlin's criteria. Most common source of thromboembolism: pelvic veins. Most common cause of acute cor pulmonale: pulmonary thromboembolism. Most specific ECG finding of pulmonary thromboembolism: S1, Q3, T3 pattern. This is a very famous repeated question in NEET PG. Investigation of choice of pulmonary thromboembolism: CT pulmonary angiogram. Most common cause of ventilator acquired pneumonia: Pseudomonas. Red currant jelly sputum is seen in Klebsiella pneumoniae. Treatment of vancomycin resistant Staphylococcus aureus: linezolid. We all know that treatment of MRSA is vancomycin, but treatment of vancomycin resistant Staph aureus is linezolid. Most common mode of spread of Legionella pneumonia: aerosol. Drug of choice for Mycoplasma pneumonia: macrolides. Drug of choice for nocardiosis: cotrimoxazole. Chromosome involved in cystic fibrosis: 7q, and the mode of inheritance is autosomal recessive. Gold standard investigation for diagnosis of cystic fibrosis, CFTR gene sequencing. Investigation of choice of bronchiectasis, HRCT chest. Most common occupational lung disease worldwide, silicosis. Most common symptom of sleep apnea, snoring. Gold standard investigation for diagnosis of sleep apnea, polysomnography. Kaplan syndrome is pneumoconiosis associated with rheumatoid arthritis. This is a frequently asked MCQ in university exams. Most common pattern of pneumonia seen in Klebsiella infection, Lobard pneumonia. Sleep apnea is defined as a temporary pause in breathing during sleep lasting at least 10 seconds. Most common cause of mediastinitis, esophageal rupture. Shock lung is better known as ARDS or adult respiratory distress syndrome. Most common bronchogenic carcinoma is adenocarcinoma. Type of lung carcinoma producing superior vena cava syndrome, small cell carcinoma. Carcinoma lung which responds best to chemotherapy, Oat cell carcinoma. Finger in glove sign results from cystic fibrosis. Presence of Velcro crackles at the lung base on auscultation is a sign of pulmonary fibrosis. Treatment of choice for pulmonary alveolar proteinosis, whole lung lavage. Most common cause of pulmonary infection in cystic fibrosis, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Most common site of secondary tuberculosis, apex of lung. Pulmonary function test not measured by spirometry, residual volume, functional residual capacity and total lung capacity. Drug of choice for H1N1 influenza, oseltamivir 75 mg twice a day for 5 days and for prophylaxis it is 75 mg once a day for 10 days. Most common cause of chylothorax, surgical trauma. Specific marker of tuberculous pleural effusion, adenosine deaminase. Gold standard investigation of tubercular pleural effusion, pleural biopsy. Most common subtype of emphysema, Sentry Acinar. Most important intervention in a patient with COPD, smoking cessation. Most common indication of lung transplantation, COPD. In type 2 respiratory failure, the parameters are low PO2 and high PCO2. Spirometry features of restrictive lung disease, FEV1 by FVC increases and compliance decreases. Leukotriene inhibitors are used in asthma for add-on therapy in patients not controlled by inhalational corticosteroids. Bronchiectasis sicca is seen with tuberculosis. Brock syndrome is bronchiectasis of middle lobe. Most common mechanism of hypoxia in humans, ventilation perfusion mismatch. Bilateral hilar lymphadenopathy along with non-caseating granulomas is a characteristic feature of sarcoidosis. Most common type of lung carcinoma in non-smokers, adenocarcinoma. The best way to make diagnosis of cystic fibrosis, sweat chloride test. Antibody used in treatment of bronchial asthma, omalizumab. In an emphysematous patient with bullous lesion, which is the best investigation to measure lung volume? Body plethysmography. This is a previous AIIMS question. Friedlander pneumonia refers to pneumonia caused by Klebsiella. Most common agent for early onset nosocomial pneumonia, Haemophilus. Most common sign of aspiration pneumonia, tachypnea. Lambda panda sign is typically seen in sarcoidosis. Treatment of choice for chlamydia pneumonia is erythromycin. Treatment of choice for sarcoidosis, prednisolone. Lastly, most common site for extrapulmonary tuberculosis, lymph nodes. So thank you everyone. I've covered 75 high yield one-liners from the topic respiratory medicine. For more such content, please like, share and subscribe to my channel.